One night Farmer Brown was taking the air, locked up the barnyard with the greatest of care. Down in the hen house something stirred when he shouted, "Who's there?" This is what he heard: "There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So calm yourself."
I'm honored to be compared to your chickens.
"There ain't nobody here but us."
Authenticity seems to imply an original, not trying to approximate a life that the chicken would want to live in this case. So things that come natural to a chicken. So we provide lots of fresh grass all the time, which comes along with insects and worms. And we provide them a nice place to lay their eggs. It seems secure, and it's slightly darkened and cozy, and a roost for them to sleep on. We don't crowd them. We're respectful of the social structure. We try not to have too many chickens in any one spot. They have their own social issues that we're always learning about. But chickens are true omnivores. So I think they have, people would say, a more pronounced chicken flavor, and that's because I guess they're more like chickens.
Chickens trying to sleep, and you butt in. And
kind of let nature write your menu for you. You follow the seasons. You cook what's local. It makes sense that it's good for you to eat what's local, what's nearby.
Well, we're in the middle of tomato season, so my goal would be that, by the end of tomato season, somewhere around mid-September, I'm so sick of tomatoes, and the people who dine here a lot are so tired of tomatoes, and the cooks are tired of tomatoes, that when the first, fall squash comes, or the first broccoli rabe comes, or the first Brussels sprouts come, we are going to be ecstatic, you know.
Enjoying the limitations of seasons, and actually find them a restraint.
Yeah.
But sort of enjoy the fact that there's certain things around for a short space of time, be it gulls' eggs or English asparagus or grouse.
And there's going to be a level of excitement and energy in the kitchen that, transforms the season and gives meaning to the fall, but also to have done justice to the summer.
It's incredible how many decisions are made for you by nature itself.
Yeah. Is the nature of what's going on, the way Jack is growing the tomatoes. But part of it, too, is the nurturing of the message.
Which I've lain down and happily given into it. Like I was saying, grouse, young grouse, marks such a fantastic point in the year. And the whole smell of it, the musk of autumn beginning. Nothing can make me happier. And bread sauce made slowly and calmly. It's a very kind of unrestaurant sauce because there's no kind of quick. It has to be calmly left. The breadcrumbs stuff up the milk and clove the onion.
Hobble, 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 hobble with your chin.
In fact, because I mean, architecture, you create space that affects people's manners of occupation. And it's cooked food that actually kind of affects people's behaviour. Yeah. It's a funny little business, which I kind of feel slightly cheeky about the whole thing, because it's what we're doing is, seems to me, back to common sense theory. What should be done to food? Just leave well alone and
keep it simple.
Yeah, and celebrate the beast. Which is in a way also a strange thing, is that kind of fait accompli of something arriving at your table that's, and in great masterly hands, it's an extraordinarily wonderful thing. This sort of concoction of food, but all your involvement really is to do is to mess it up and sort of eat it. But going back to that food and power theory, it's amazing how unnerved people are sometimes about food or their appreciation of food and the whole process of eating.
Yeah.
And it's St. John's not really about reassuring you. It's the fact is you eat well and you have a lovely time.
Yeah.
You become a decoration.
Yeah.
And the sound of wine being poured and happy eating and merry chat.
There ain't nobody here but us chickens.
Our kitchen scraps are divided into four different receptacles. We have regular trash, and we have chicken trash, which is proteins for the most part, a little bit of vegetative stuff, but for the most part, proteins.
Blimey.
And so,
that's a labor of love in the kitchen.
They go back to the laying hens, and then we have a compost pile mainly made up of eggshells. And then for the pigs, we take all the vegetable scraps in the kitchen.
That is the benefit of cooking on a farm.
Yeah.
In central London, there's not much kind of... So I can't imagine getting our kitchen porters to separate. Chicken feed, the pig feed, and the compost.
Nobody here at all.